Today, OpenAI released its newest and most advanced model, GPT-4 Omni. I've had a couple of hours to play with it, and it is pretty cool. I'm going to show you all that there is to know about this new model and a couple of drawbacks. Let's do this. Hey there, it is I versus AI. This is the newest blog post from OpenAI. And the first thing I noticed was this really cool little read-along section that allows you to listen to the blog post in one of the voices that's also available in the ChatGPT user interface. You can choose a voice here. I'm going to choose my favorite, Breeze.
May 13th, 2024. Hello. We're announcing GPT-4o, our new flagship model that can reason across audio, vision, and text in real time.
Now, OpenAI has given us a lot of information here, and I encourage you, if you haven't had a chance to see some of these examples, they're pretty mind-blowing. But the first disappointment I have to share with you is that these examples are not available to us yet. We do have access to the model itself that can output text, but these really cool examples that we have here of Greg showing these two AIs here and two different phones, and they're talking to each other and they can even sing back and forth. Amazing, but not available yet. OpenAI promises that these new capabilities will be rolling out in the next few weeks. In the meantime, you can either take a look at some of the capabilities, and they're really cool. Photo-to-caricature is awesome, like these OpenAI employees that are being turned into caricatures. This looks really cool and really amazing. I wonder how much you can change the style of what the output is with the character. But these images really look just like, it's just like the picture. So I'm very impressed with this example. Another cool example that is so useful is to have GPT-4o output an actual font, create an entire new font for you. And then you can upload this. There are font creation sites where you can put each letter in and create a font just perfect for your own branding. I love this idea. One of the more basic use cases that you can do is a meeting. And this audio, I'm going to play a bit of it because it's not really great audio. Let's listen to this audio.
Okay, good morning. This is our first team meeting.
Morning.
Morning.
I'll be your project manager for today, for this project.
Okay, first of all, those guys really don't sound like they want to be in that meeting at all. The model does do a great job of transcribing it with the speaker names. That is really cool, especially since at no point in the prompt did the user prompt what the speaker's names were. That was taken from the audio. The model was able to determine which speaker was which and then keep that determination going throughout the transcribed text. That's amazing. Here's another example. This is really fun. This is character consistency. You can output something like this robot with a baseball hat on. If you upload the initial image and prompt again for the robot to be doing something else, it does indeed keep the character consistency of the output. This is a game changer. Now, there have been a lot of videos. In fact, I have done a video on how to get character consistency out of DALL-E. However, it requires some finagling and it requires using seeds and that kind of thing. This is simply upload the image of the initial character and have that character do different things, and it maintains that consistency. So this is a real game changer. Now, I'm looking at the desktop version here of ChatGPT-4o, and the first thing you'll notice is that I don't have access to the desktop app. That is because there isn't a desktop app for Windows yet. Though I obviously can't confirm this, I did see this Reddit post that says that, well, you can't even get it if you have an Intel Mac. You need a Silicon Mac. I don't know anything about Macs, but just keep that in mind if you can't get the app to work or you can't even find the download. Which, by the way, if you do have a Mac, when you log in to ChatGPT, you'll get a notification that there is an app available. So could someone confirm that that is showing up for you if you are on a Mac? The first thing you're going to notice when you start using the new Omni model is the speed. Now, I've noticed that I always have to check up here to make sure that Omni is being chosen. It sometimes defaults to GPT-4, and that's confused me. So make sure that you do indeed have GPT-4o. I'm old. It reminds me of Hawaii 5-0. Anyone else? I've just dated myself. Anyway, GPT-4o. Let's ask the model for a quick story so you can see how quickly it outputs this text. I'd like you to tell me a story, a children's story about a little red ball, but I want it to also help me understand the futility of the human condition. That is speedy, much faster than GPT-4. But I noticed something immediately. The writing that ChatGPT Omni is outputting is much, much better than ChatGPT-4. This is a Reddit thread that I love because it talks about all the different words that ChatGPT overuses. Transformative, framework, cultivate, and my favorite, tapestry. This word shows up in almost every ChatGPT-4 story. So let's look at the output and see if ChatGPT Omni is also overusing these words. Yeah, I'm scrolling through and I'm not seeing any of those overused words. And I happen to know for sure that ChatGPT loved these words because just last night I was using the older model, ChatGPT-4. Very similar story. I had the same exact prompt, show me a little red ball and the futility of the human condition. And there was a tapestry in there every time. And now it's gone. This is my YouTube prompt. I love this prompt. It creates a great YouTube description. What we're looking at here is the last output I did. And this is a very standard, typical output from GPT-4. It's got this intro paragraph here, and I'm sharing how you can do it too. I demonstrate how to leverage it for daily tasks, manage a D&D campaign. This writing isn't bad. It's just still a little bit stilted. So let's look at what Omni output for the same exact prompt. Much better. We still have transformed. In this case, though, I'm going to let that slide because I literally did transform ChatGPT's memory feature into my own personal Jarvis. So it is exactly right. But I love that it's just more realistic and to the point. Let's take a look at this down here. This is the paragraph that always gives a little bit more detail as to what's in the video, what the viewer can expect. In this detailed guide, I dive into ChatGPT's memory feature, showcasing its potential as a versatile tool for personal productivity and entertainment. Again, there's still a kind of stiltedness to this. Now, it was fine and it worked okay, but let's see what Omni does with this. I've explored ChatGPT's memory feature, which allows it to remember details across conversations, making it more helpful over time. Bam. This to me is better writing than ChatGPT-4. And since we all want to use it to create content like for social media, yeah, this is much better and easier to read. And when I read this, I wouldn't immediately say an AI wrote this. Now, on the other hand, every model that you have has a particularness to it. And there's really no way to get around that. So the way the hype cycle works is that this looks fresh and new to us, but give us 6 months, we might see the sameness in this text output too. That's the way it worked when ChatGPT first came on the scene using 3.5, when 4 came on the scene, and now when 4.0 is here as well too. Now, if you want to change the output of a model, you can actually do so right here, just changing the model on the fly. So that's pretty cool. And when you change it, it will regenerate and give you a new output using that model. So you can compare the writing between all three models. Now, I've got another fun use case for you here. This evolution of the alphabet. This was uploaded by Vanderl on Reddit today, and it's a neat use case. Now, I did try this myself on the desktop version of ChatGPT and did not get quite the same results they did, but I'm going to show you it anyway, just to show you what is possible. The user said, I uploaded this image and then told it to write replies using the alphabet from the top row, and it worked. Let's take a look at their response. Now, because we can't see the entirety of the prompt here, we have to just wonder what was going on before this, if there was something crucial that made it difficult for me to reproduce this. However, we do see that ChatGPT in the app comes back with these symbols, but it's pretty cool to see that ChatGPT could write in this symbolic language. So I'm curious to see if this works. Go ahead and give it a try. I will upload a link to this image And you can try it on your ChatGPT mobile app and let me know how it works. The Playground allows you to play with models through the API. And you can see over here, you have ChatGPT 4 Omni selected. You can upload images. So I'm going to copy this evolution of the alphabet and I'm going to ask it to output text. Now I'm going to run this. I'm not sure if it's going to work because I don't know if the Playground has access to the new vision aspect of the Omni model, or if it would be using the old vision, GPT-4 vision. Let's go ahead and find out. Awesome. It was able to do it. It gave me archaic Greek and it showed me the entire alphabet and the symbols. Let's see if it can say something like, hello, good morning, in ancient Greek using the symbols. Again, the output is very, very quick and it does show the symbols. It seems to work. There is the symbols there. They look similar to the image. I won't do a one-by-one comparison, but yeah, this looks really cool. So this is a use case as well too. I admit, one that we may not find an everyday use case for, but it just gets the brain moving on what you could do with this. That would be admittedly a little bit more practical. Confident Hand 5837 here on Reddit uploaded an image of GPT-4 Turbo versus the new GPT-4 Omni. I know that this says, hello, R singularity. I can just tell that, even though I can only see half the text. But GPT-4 could not see that and thought it was a barcode or some scannable code. But GPT-4 Omni says that the text appears to say, hello, R singularity. It does look like the Playground model is using the new vision tool of GPT-4 Omni. But it did fail on a test I like to run. This is my Michael Jackson's studio wall test. This image is a photograph of Michael Jackson's family home at Havenhurst, the studio in that family home. And on the wall is a quote by a fellow famous musician. The text is pretty difficult to read, but there's enough of it that the model may be able to determine who the quote is from if we upload the image and be able to read the entire image. Let's go ahead and see if it works. All right, for the prompt here, I put, this is an image of text on the wall of Michael Jackson's studio. It's a quote from a famous musician he admired. Can you read the entire quote, please? I will admit that I am cheating a little bit. I did upload this image earlier with just the simple prompt of tell me what the text in this image says, and it did not get it correct. It got some of it correct, but not the very difficult to read part. So I'm now prompting it and letting it know that it is a quote from another famous musician. Let's see if it can get it. Actually, it's pretty close, but it's not correct. This is the correct quote by John Lennon. When the real music comes to me, the music of the spheres, the music that surpasses understanding, that has nothing to do with me, because I'm just the channel. The only joy for me is for it to be given to me and to transcribe it like a medium. Those are the moments I live for. John Lennon. Once I gave Omni the exact artist, it was able to pull the quote exactly. All right, so let's talk about the pros and cons so far of the new Omni tool. The writing is so much better. The vision tool, at least what we tried out in the API, definitely seems to be improved over the old model. The voice capabilities, well, we can't test them yet because they're not available and won't be out for the next few weeks. So we're going to need to have some patience. But the most important thing by far is that the model is much faster, at least for now. I've noticed that new models come out and they always seem faster, but there is a cost to pay for that speed. And sometimes that cost is in its reasoning and intelligence. But from what I have read, ChatGPT-4 Omni does absolutely beat GPT-4 in tests for reasoning. So time will tell. Even though ChatGPT-4 Omni's writing is definitely an improvement, you're still going to have to understand how to prompt the model. Part of prompting is understanding which words have heavy bias to produce a certain output. If you'd like to learn how to make ChatGPT write more like you sound, I did a video a while back and those tricks still stand today. And they work wonders for turning ChatGPT into a writing machine. That video is on screen right now.